Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Oluwaseyi Daralayemi John Mote, and this is my YouTube channel. On this YouTube channel, I talk about faith, career, relationships, lifestyle, and every other good stuff. Basically, I just learn and share. And if this is your first time, thank you so much. Thank you for clicking on this video when you saw it. Please do subscribe to the channel. Give this video a thumbs up, like the video, and then click on the notification bell just beside the subscribe button. just beside the subscribe button so that whenever I post a new video, you'll be the first person to be aware. And if you are a viewer and you've not subscribed, I beg you, it's just totally free. Just subscribe. Please subscribe and leave a comment and share and do every other good stuff that you need to do. So welcome back to my YouTube channel. And as you might have seen the title already, this time around we're going to be talking about something that I think that a lot of youth are very confused about. I have heard a lot of people, I can't even count how many people have said, like how many people have complained about this, or I've just said it in passing, or I've just like heard people just lament or ask questions about it. And then I decided to just share from my own knowledge and experience. Now, I said my knowledge, right? What I know. And by the leading of this Holy Spirit, God helped me to say all that I know. Yes. So, basically, we're just going to be talking about what happens when... I don't know what the topic is going to be exactly, but I know that it's going to be something around what if I did not hear God, love, or must I really hear God before I can go ahead to marry he or she? Or what if I did not really hear from God? Can I really go ahead to marry this person? Or how am I convinced that this is the right person for me since I don't hear from God? Or people that don't hear from God, does that make them less qualified to marry the right person? Whatever title that I'm able to give this, when I'm done editing and when I'm posting the video, I'm going to give it. But for now, let's just talk about light out. Okay, so what happens when you really didn't hear God say, or you didn't hear God open his mouth to say, this is the person that you should marry, now go ahead and marry this person? Like, I know that a lot of times people want to be sure that they heard from God, because marriage is a very important journey, and it's a journey to forever. So at some point, you need to be sure, like very, 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 very sure, beyond reasonable doubts, that God is leading you towards this person. But then, not everybody is going to hear from God. The truth is, not everybody hears from God. Or not everybody hears God clearly. Everybody, God speaks to everybody, but not everybody would hear God clearly. There are some people who are gifted with, hearing God with the still voice and all of that. I mean, we know that the redeemed general overseer, and like some other people that you hear them say, oh, my father said that, they are hearing God clearly. But I mean, a lot of us do not hear God clearly. I cannot say that, okay, this is God that is already talking, like God is talking now. Let us just be, I mean, some of us, I joke a lot with the fact that I'm a talkative and I'm busy talking. If God is even talking, I don't even know he's talking. But the truth is, God speaks to everybody in different ways. God speaks to us through dreams and visions. God speaks to people through clear signs. God speaks to people through scripture, through counsel from other people and convictions from other people. God speaks to us through other people also. God speaks to us through the scriptures. God speaks to us through inner convictions. God speaks to us through peace. God speaks to us through a lot of ways. Do you understand? It's just for you to know how God speaks to you and to stick by it. The truth is, because you are about to get married, doesn't mean that God is going to speak to you differently. Whichever way God has been speaking to you all this while is how God is going to speak to you when he needs to speak to you concerning your life partner. And I mean, how did God speak to you when you were supposed to go on a particular journey, or you're supposed to pass a route, and something just told you in your mind that, oh, don't go through this route, and you did not go through that route, and guess what, you found out that something bad happened on the route? Or what happened when you were supposed to do something, like you're supposed to do it in a certain way, and you started to just do it a little bit different? Something just told you to do it a little bit different, and you did it, and boom, it brought out like very tremendous results. What do you think spoke to you? Did you find your village or the angel in heaven? What spoke to you? It is It is the same Holy Spirit that has been speaking to you through those things inside of you that has still spoken to you concerning, that will still speak to you concerning your life partner. And I also want to like establish the fact that there is really no such thing. I mean, God will not impose himself on you. I need to let you know that fact. God is not going to impose himself on you. God is not going to say, you must marry this person. He's just going to direct you. He's just going to tell you what to do. It's now left for you to follow his plan for. And there's something like the perfect will and permissive will. And another thing I also want you to look, just look at this scenario. The thing is, okay, so look at the path. Look at those people that would get married and then they will lose their spouse and they'll get married to another person. They will enjoy, they will have two beautiful marriages. Like they had a wonderful marriage and then they probably lost their spouse and they are remarried and they are enjoying this same marriage. What I'm trying to say is that there is no perfect partner for you, that if you don't get married to this person, you would never have to get married to, you would never find another person that suits you. There is really no such thing like that. I mean, you also see cases where you're convinced in your mind that this is the person for me, and the person that you're convinced about is not convinced, and the person doesn't choose to marry you. I keep telling people that God is not going to, he's not going to let his daughter or his son suffer because you have refused to be you have been disobedient or you have refused to take heed to his instructions. If God is saying that you two are for each other, and for some reason the significant other does not see or does not believe in that vision or in that word, it doesn't mean that the other person is going to have to suffer maritally because one person has not decided to come or be yoked with you. Mm-mm. So it just means that there is really no, like, there is no one perfect person for you. Now, there is goodwill and there is Godwill. Do we get that? I mean, I hope we get that that aspect. Now, major thing is, so now let's just go to the major reason why I'm doing this video, which is the fact that I did not hear from God doesn't mean that I'm doing the right thing, or am I sure that this is the right person for me even though I cannot hear from God. So the thing is, I've said that there are a lot of ways that God speaks to people, a lot of ways, and it's just firstly for you to know how God has been speaking to you. Now, if you have not had that relationship with God ever since, and now it's time to get married, try to remove all options that you have. So sometimes we have our options, we know our plans, and we just come to God just to put him in it, and we just try to drag God into our plans and everything. And when it doesn't work out, you're like, God, I thought I involved you in this from the beginning. The truth is, you didn't involve God. You brought somebody to God and you presented the person, and God allowed you to get married, and something is going on. You're leaning down and say, God, this person you have blessed me with, did God really bless you with the person? So, and sometimes when we are with somebody and we now go to God in prayer, we begin to see that person. So the truth is, just be, when you go to God in prayer, or when you go to God requesting to know, to have convictions about somebody, also be willing to accept whatever response you get. So you have now gone to God in prayer, you're not hearing anything, but somebody that you respect a lot, maybe your spiritual parent or your parent, or maybe a prayer partner, has now told you that God is saying that this is not the person for you, but you cannot accept it because you feel like, oh no, I've spent 5-10 years with this person, I cannot leave this person alone. You have to go to God with open mind that, God, this is me. Whatever the response is, I take it. Another thing I'm going to say is, when it comes to seeking the face of God towards the issue of life partner or getting married and what have you, the truth is, you need to be patient. You cannot rush God. You need to be patient. If you want to be sure that that God is saying that this is the person, you need to be patient. The truth is, if you start praying today, that don't mean that God must respond to you today or tomorrow or three weeks after. You can't be giving God time and make sure that he follows that plan and all of that. You need to be patient with God. He can say no, he can say wait, he can say go on. You need to be patient with God. You need to be patient with God. And then also, if you don't have that relationship with God where you can say this is clearly God, you can request to have clear signs. And that's why I tell a lot of people, if you know you don't have that relationship with God initially, but you want to be sure that this is it, because a lot of times people just say, I had peace concerning. That's what you people just keep saying, so that nobody will have to be against your union. Everybody just comes to say, I had peace. But the truth is, beyond peace and all of that, you need to have clear signs. So for people who do not have that relationship with God where you can say, I heard God clearly. For example, I did not hear God. because in God has, I've never had a, been at that point where I can say I heard God. Yes, I've had my spirit indulge, but I've had nudges my spirit where I go, where I follow whatever my spirit is saying, and it turns out well. I know how God speaks to me, but I really cannot say, oh, I heard the very silent voice or the very thick shaking voice and all of that. But I had clear signs. I had layers and layers and layers of conviction. My spouse on the other hand had his own personal convictions also. He heard God. So, and because he, I cannot say because he heard God, I heard God also. The truth is, I mean, he knows that if he needs to speak with me, he needs to tell God to speak to me. But then God is also not going to speak to me the way he spoke to him, because now I'm not going to be hearing. You know how communication is. You're talking, somebody's listening, somebody's understanding what you're saying. So if God is talking and I'm not listening, then I'm not understanding. And there's no communication going on. So God will have to speak to me in a way that I will understand. And the way I will understand is through the way he has been speaking to me over time. So if you have not had that relationship with God over time, one is to start requesting now, whether you're in a relationship or not, start praying for your life partner, start praying that you'll be at the right place at the right time. Because there's also a case of you being in a wrong place, or you praying to God and not waiting to receive instructions from God. Because God can say, oh, go and take a course. Maybe that's where you're going to meet your spouse. Oh, go and join a particular department in church. Maybe that's where you're going to meet your spouse. You don't know. But you're just praying. You're not listening to instructions. You need to listen to instructions also and be patient with God. But beyond that also, if you are now at that point where you are in a relationship at the moment, and you're not sure that you heard God, but to a large extent you want to be convinced about the relationship, you want to be sure that yes, this is the right person for me, but you know that you cannot hear God, I would advise that you start praying from today, from now that you've watched this video, that God should give you clear signs. I mean, you hear stories of people that say, oh, the first person I wanted this particular person to say this particular thing if he is the right person for me, and in the morning he said that same thing. Do you understand? So start asking God for clear, those kind of signs that you know, because the truth is, God speaks, devil speaks. So who are you listening to? People, devil speaks, God speaks. So the fact that something is speaking to you, it does not mean that it's God that is speaking to you. Let me just say that. Let me just clear that. The fact that so you're hearing doesn't mean that God is God that is speaking. Devil also speaks. You need to be sure beyond reasonable. I mean, there's some kind of conviction, the kind of signs that you will see. And you will know that this is God. And he said, this is God. I mean, there are places where you meet the person and you're like, ow, like I wasn't even supposed to be here at this particular time, or this is just showing that it's a God incident. I call my relationship a God incident story, because even the way we met, it was just coincidence, but I know that it was just God divinely orchestrating it. So I call it a God incident story. So you can begin to ask God for clear signs. I mean, you can even say, God, this is how I want to meet my spouse. If you can take this, fine. But you can just say, God, I want to give. And you can also begin to pray for layers of convictions. For instance, even beyond me, wanting to have convictions, I also had people around me, they had like their own convictions. So they had like layers and layers and layers of convictions. If by now you should have watched my video where I spoke about parental disapproval, and that process also was another conviction for me, because everybody that was against me getting married began to have their own convictions, which became another conviction for me. And then I mean, it went through process, because the truth is, time is the test of true patience, or time is the test of true character. There are a lot of things that God will begin to expose with you if you are just being patient with him and you're going through right process. So the fact that you did not hear from God clearly doesn't mean that you cannot get it right in the place of marriage. And the fact that God has even spoken to you doesn't mean that the fact that you heard from God clearly doesn't mean that the relationship is going to be perfect. Mm-mm. You are going to need to also put in the work. If you have watched my video, I spoke about trusting God for a partner. Beyond you just getting a partner, you also need to put in the work. You need to get the training manual, which is the Bible. You need to seek counseling to also help you to improve. And you also need to put in the work and be sure that the marriage is going to work. Because beyond God speaking to you, he's not also going to come down to help you paddle the boat or the relationship. You need to also you need to also follow guidelines, follow principles, and paddle your relationship well. I really hope this helps someone. I really hope this helps people who are confused about how they are going to get it right in their relationship and all of that. I really hope this speaks to you, or this helps you to know how to begin to channel your thoughts, or channel your prayers, or channel your mindset. The truth is, everybody would not hear from God. Everybody, God will not always speak to everybody in the same way. And because you've heard over and over and over again, you know, there was a time that I always felt that I was going to meet my spouse in church, because almost everybody around me was meeting their spouse in church, and I just felt like it was just right for me to meet my spouse in church. So also, don't use another person's story or another person's time or another person's process to judge yours. God handles us differently. And you need to understand your journey, understand your process, understand how God speaks to you. And beyond anything, be ready, be patient, wait, trust God for the best, and be sure. If you are not sure about something, don't go into it, because when you start the relationship, the devil will come, it will try you. There are a lot of times where you will see some characters. For example, there were times in the relationship where I was beginning to doubt that, is this God? Is this not God? And guess what? My spouse was doing things. His character at that period was trying to make me see that, I'm not sure God is talking to me. But guess what? Every time I was feeling like doubt, all of that, I would always say, God, I need convictions. And God will always give me another conviction. I had a lot of convictions, layers and layers and layers of convictions. So if you're not sure that this relationship is right, even if you're already in a relationship, you can begin to pray and tell God to reveal the person to you. And trust God, it's not an author of confusion, it's always going to come true. I really hope this video will bless somebody, to help somebody who has been going through that confusion at that this particular time. I always say that if my video blesses just one person, I'm very fine. Because beyond the likes, beyond the subscriber count and all of that, I do my videos to bless somebody, to edify someone, and to save someone from confusion or destruction. I pray that God blesses your heart, God gives you divine, God gives you clearance, and God helps you to be able to scale through this and help other people to scale through this. Thank you very much for watching to the end of this video. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like it, share it, and till next time I post another video, remain blessed. I love you all. Bye. Oh,